Hey guys, Jonathan from Online Business Accelerator, coming at you today with a quick, effective tip for boosting the rate and quality of your website inquiries. And just before I reveal these tactics, one of the very first questions new clients will ask is, how do we get our website to spit out more customer leads? Can you guys relate to that challenge? Well, if you're watching this video, then you probably can. And you are very much in the majority. It's true. And in over 10 years of consultancy and working with hundreds of ambitious businesses, I'm yet to come across one business owner happy with their website performance. Yep, ouch. You see, underwhelming websites is the rule, not the exception. And your web designer, as talented as they might be in the design and development space, they're not marketers. And don't set up your site to cater for your prospects' wants and needs. And in fact, you should never expect a designer to create a website that is profitable for your business. I mean, it's a bit like expecting your accountant to look after your legal needs. You know, they're different disciplines, and that's where we as digital strategists can help. So a quick fire method for generating more and better leads from your website is to simply tweak your existing contact form. And I'm going to give you three contact form tactics which can help reap immediate results for your business. Does that work for you? Well, the first one is to stop viewing your contact form like your phone voicemail. Now, I've yet to meet a business owner that enjoys playing phone or email tag with prospects. So let's avoid this time expensive cat and mouse game altogether. So instead of asking your visitors to just leave a message, use a conditional logic form. And there's lots of free software tools out there. But use this type of form to get the prospect to really understand why they're contacting you. And you can achieve this by providing them with a choice of services, products, or solutions that's going to help them overcome their current challenges and frustrations. Now, here's the kicker. Depending on their choice, you can then ask them to rate their motivation for you to solve their current problem. Why? Because now you've pre-qualified this prospect before any contact is made, and even better, they're even more aware of their problem and their urgency for you to provide the solution. Two birds, one simple question. So could you use a qualifying question like this for your service or product? Okay, the second contact form tactic is to obtain a day and time to contact your website prospect. Now, ideally, you want them booking a slot in your calendar. And this might be a free and short needs analysis call just to further qualify and close this prospect over the phone and then set up their initial paid appointment. So your booking system will send an automated text or email reminder the day or a few hours before this call to decrease the rate of no-shows. And this closing strategy will then overcome any objections and build the trust you'll need to convert this warm prospect into a customer. And this brings us to the third and final contact form hack, which is all about permission marketing. Now, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, guys, but newsletter signups these days are about as appealing as catching influenza on the first day of your summer holiday. So remedy this by including a pre-selected opt-in checkbox at the bottom of your contact form. Something along the line of, want our best tips, resources, and advice on your subject, and that's it. This website inquirer pops off into your MailChimp list or welcome email sequence. I'll talk about that in a future video. But the point is, you've easily generated a warm subscriber, and all without having to mention that buzzkill newsletter word. So the contact form does all the grunt work for you. So here's a quick recap on transforming your contact form. Firstly, help your prospect build more awareness around their needs with a simple rate your pain type question. Second, make sure you request a date and time to call this prospect back, or ideally have them book into your calendar for that initial needs analysis call. And then finally, leverage your contact page inquiries with a pre-selected opt-in box, and then the prospect can get your future email tips and promotions. That's a wrap, guys. If you found this short video helpful, or if you'd like to share any website challenges you're facing right now, then we'd love to hear from you. Just let us know in the comments below. Or if you'd like further web tactics and a whole stack of our best client marketing resources, time-saving templates and swipe sheets, we'd love to share more business nuggets with you inside our No Fluff marketing community on Facebook, set up for purpose-driven businesses looking to make a greater impact. And you'll be able to access this group through the link below or above this video. Who really knows? But take care for now, and I'll see you in the group.